हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम एनके जैन फ्रॉम स्किल ऑन टेक। टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट लोकेटिंग एंड नॉन लोकेटिंग बियरिंग्स विच आर यूज्ड इन पंप्स एंड रोटेटिंग मशीन्स। इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ बियरिंग्स इन रोटेटिंग मशीन्स। इन दिस स्लाइड यू कैन सी ए पिक्चर ऑफ ए पंप वेयर टू बियरिंग्स आर इंस्टॉल्ड, दिस वन एंड this one. These two bearings are called locating and non-locating bearings. So first let us understand why bearings are very important in pumps, because they are used to support shaft and reduce friction during rotation. They are provided to take static and dynamic load of rotating members. Bearings are prone to subjected radial and axial hydraulic thrust because of process fluid. Therefore, selection of suitable bearing and provision of bearing in pump at right location is very important to have a long life of bearing to ensure continuous operation of pump. Pump failures may be disaster for production of industry, because process pumps are heart of the pump. Hence, careful selection and installation of bearing is very important. Representation of radial and axial load on bearings. Here in this slide you can see a picture where you can see this is a bearing and this is a radial load on the bearing, and the load which is in the direction of axis of a shaft is called axial load. So these radial loads and axial loads are subjected on bearing, and bearings are subjected to take both the loads and have to withstand against the load and ensure a smooth operation of the pump. Locating and non-locating bearing. A picture is shown where you can see in the picture that this is a locating bearing where the bearing is fixed with the housing location, and it has to take axial load and radial load, both loads means combined radial and axial loads. The other is one is a non-locating side that will accommodate axial displacement of a shaft due to thermal expansion. If both bearings are made locating bearings, then thermal expansion will not be accommodated and shaft may cause to bend. Suppose if we make it also fixed, then shaft may bend because it will not provide an thermal expansion tolerance. Hence, in all the rotating machines, one bearing is provided locating and other one is provided non-locating bearing. The locating and non-locating bearings positions can be changed with respect to machine positionings. Generally in a horizontal pumps, the driving end of a pump is made locating and non-driving end is made non-locating and provide to accommodate thermal expansion and give a axial displacement tolerance. The load, radial load and axial load may vary pump to pump. Therefore, bearings are designed with respect to load of the pump bearing for locating support. The bearing in the locating position, which is typically positioned at the drive end of a machine, support the shaft radially and locate it axially in both directions. It must therefore be fixed in a position both on the shaft and in the housing. Suitable bearing type for locating supports are deep groove ball bearings. A picture of a deep groove ball bearing is shown. So this bearing will be suitable for accommodating radial and axial loads. So in continuation of locating bearings, some more bearings are shown. Two universally matchable single row angular contact ball bearings arranged back to back or face to face. You can see a picture of a face to face arrangement of this angular contact ball bearing, and this is a back to back arrangement of a angular contact ball bearing. Here you can see a picture of a single row angular contact ball bearing, and these two pictures are double row angular contact ball bearings. So these are also suitable for locating bearings. Some more locating bearings are self aligning ball bearings, spherical roller bearings, matched tapered roller bearings arranged back to back or face to face, cylindrical roller bearings with flanges on both rings, or cylindrical roller bearings mounted with an angle ring thrust collar. So here you can see in this picture, this is a matched tapered roller bearing, this is a spherical roller bearing. You can see these rollers are in spherical shape. Here in a taper roller bearing, rollers are of cylindrical rollers but are arranged in a tapered manner at an angle in a bearing, and this is a self-aligning ball bearing which accommodate misalignments. Bearing combinations for locating support. You can see a picture where a combination of bearing is shown. The locating bearing support can consist of a combination of bearing to accommodate the radial load, a cylindrical roller bearing that has one ring without flange may be used. You can see here in this picture, this is a roller without flange. To provide the axial location, a deep groove ball bearing or a 4-point contact ball bearing or a pair of angular contact ball bearing may be used. You can see here, this is a 4-point contact ball bearing. The outer ring of axial locating bearing must be mounted radially free and should not be clamped. Otherwise, this bearing can be subjected to unintended radial loads. Bearing for non-locating support. You can see a picture of cylindrical roller bearings NU and N design, which is given here. These. There are two ways to accommodate axial displacement at the non-locating bearing support. First method is use a bearing type that enable axial displacement. Axial displacement means this in both the direction within the bearing, like cylindrical roller bearing with flange on one ring only. So here you can see in this picture, this is a cylindrical roller bearing with NU design. So in this bearing you can see the flange is only this side. This is a flange and here it is free for axial displacement. इन एंड डिजाइन द फ्लैंजेस एट हियर बॉटम साइड दिस एंड हियर इट इज फ्री सो इट कैन मूव एक्सियली इन बोथ द डायरेक्शंस हियर ऑल्सो यू कैन सी द फ्लैंजेस शोन फ्लैंजेस हियर इन एट द आउटर रेस एंड दिस इनर रेस इज फ्री टू गिव एक्सियल मूवमेंट Here are some more non-locating bearings. You can see a picture of needle roller bearing here, and here it is a CARB toroidal roller bearing. When these bearings are rotating, they accommodate axial displacement and induce almost no axial load on the bearing arrangement. So these bearings will provide axial displacement in both the directions. This solution should be used where an interference fit is required for both rings. Here it is a at the outer race it is a flanged, but in the inner race it is free to move. And similarly, this CRB toroidal roller bearing is free to move axially in both the directions in inner and outer race. Non-locating bearings. The second method, use a loose fit between one bearing ring and its seat. So, by keeping a loose fit, it will provide an space for axial displacement. Suitable bearing types include deep groove ball bearing, self-aligned ball bearing, angular contact ball bearing, spherical roller bearings, tapered roller bearings. Axial movement of a bearing on its seat causes axial loads which might have an impact on the bearing service life. It will not provide an axial displacement clearance in the bearing, then the axial load will impact on the bearing and will fail it. Typical combination of bearing supports. For bearing arrangements where the axial displacement is accommodated within the bearings are deep groove ball bearing, cylindrical roller bearings, NUP design cylindrical roller bearings or NU design cylindrical roller bearings. NU design cylindrical roller bearing and a 4-point contact ball bearing. The top of the 4-point contact ball bearing will be free to accommodate axial load. NU design cylindrical roller bearing. Double row angular contact ball bearing, NU or N design cylindrical roller bearing, matched single row tapered roller bearing, NU or N design cylindrical roller bearing. If we'll not keep a provision for axial displacement, then the axial load will impact on the bearing and bearing may fail. Typical combination of bearing supports. Here you can see this is a deep groove ball bearing and this is a cylindrical roller bearing. So these bearings basically allow axial movement inside of the bearing. Here you can see in this cylindrical roller bearing the inner rays provide a axial movement and outer rays is flange type. Deep groove ball bearings are generally not give axial movement because they are having very less tolerances for axial movement. The other combination is NUP design cylindrical roller bearing. This one and NU design cylindrical roller bearing. So here in these type of bearings, there is a loose fit between bearing ring and its seat. So in NU style bearing, you can see there is no flange in the inner race and outer race is having machine flange. So this NU design cylindrical roller bearing will not be enough to take any thrust load. Instead of this, in NUP design cylindrical roller bearing, you can see in the inner race, there is a one end is flanged and this end is free, and here this is a collar. The inner race is extended, so this collar will provide to take thrust load. So NUP style bearings are similar to NJ style bearings. This is one more typical combination of bearing supports. So here you can see this is a 4-point contact ball bearing and this is NU design cylindrical roller bearing. So this 4-point contact ball bearing will provide movement for axial displacement. The top of the outer race, this outer race is free to provide little axial movements. So they are able to take axial loads. Here also in this NU design cylindrical roller bearing, the inner ring is without flange and will also give a compensation for axial movements. Here also you can see in this roller bearing, the inner race is free to take axial loads and provide axial movement inside of the bearing itself. A double row angular contact ball bearing will also provide axial movements and take axial loads and also compensate angular misalignments. And this NU design cylindrical roller bearing we already discussed. You can see here will provide an axial movement and take axial loads. The picture shown is a matched single row tapered roller bearing. Here you can see, and a NU or N design cylindrical roller bearing. So these kind of typical combination of bearing supports are provided for locating and non-locating bearings. Here you can see a spherical roller bearing and a CARB toroidal roller bearing. So this will be a locating bearing and this will be a non-locating bearing. This non-locating bearing will provide an axial displacement. Self-aligning bearing system which can compensate for more misalignments. A spherical roller bearing, CARB toroidal roller bearing, self-aligning ball bearing or CARB toroidal roller bearings are used. Typical combination of bearing supports. Here you can see in this picture, a deep groove ball bearing and deep groove ball bearing combination is given. For bearing arrangement where the axial displacement is accommodated between a bearing ring and its seat. So in this combination, the axial displacement will be accommodated between bearing ring and its seat. So this is a ball and this is a seat. So here you can see this is a outer ring, outer case. So the displacement will be accommodated by outer race and ball. So these bearings will provide only a little movement in the bearing. Self-aligning ball bearings or spherical roller bearings, matched single row angular contact ball bearing or deep groove ball bearing are also installed for a typical combination of bearing supports to take axial loads and radial loads and as well as to provide axial displacement inside of the bearing ring and its seat. Here in this picture you can see a typical combination of bearing support of a spherical roller bearing or a spherical roller bearing. Here you can see this is a spherical roller bearing and this is also a spherical roller bearing. So this can be used for locating and non-locating bearing combination. And this other one is a matched single row angular contact ball bearing here and a deep groove ball bearing. This combination is also used for locating and non locating ball bearing combination. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, hit like button below, share it with your friends and colleagues, subscribe our channel for getting updates on upcoming videos. Please leave any comments, feedback to improve the videos. Thank you.